So now we're going to look at a funny shaped track with the same skater. And the reason for this, let's see in a second. What happens if the gravitational potential energy goes down and then back up again? That's what this track is, or is doing for us. What I have, if I put the skater up at the top here, stop this thing, put the skater up there, here's the total potential energy, because I've raised the skater up. As the skater goes along this track, the potential energy will go down as the skater gets lower, and so the kinetic energy will go up. And then, because the track is shaped this way, the skater is going to have to go back up again. And as the skater goes back up, the potential energy will have to go back up, and the kinetic energy will go back down. And let's just watch what happens. Faster and faster as potential energy goes down, and then slower and slower, and then faster again. And then slower and slower and slower, back to the same height, same potential energy. And then speeds up. Notice that the change in potential energy is not very fast here as the skater goes along. So the skater doesn't pick up speed very quickly. This is actually associated with the way the potential energy changes with location is related to the force. When you're up here, there's a force on the skater toward lower potential energy. So the skater is going to be pulled to the left. As the slope gets steeper, the skater will be pulled harder and harder to the left. And then here, the slope is in the other direction. The lower potential energy is to the right, so the skater is pulled to the right. Now the skater is being pulled to the left again. Pulled to the left means the skater is slowing down. Slowing down, stopping. And then pulled to the left means speeding up to the left, faster and faster. When the skater gets past this point, the skater will be pulled to the right, and so the skater will slow down, stop right there, and then come back again. So highest potential energy at this point, this is called a turning point, where the skater stops, turns around, comes back. That's where the potential energy is the highest, and the kinetic energy is zero. Then the kinetic energy goes up. Notice what happens when he gets to the left. The kinetic energy goes down to zero right there. Maybe I'll stop it the next time through. That's another turning point. So here's a turning point coming up soon where the skater stops and turns to the left. And there will be another turning point on the left where the skater stops, turns to the right. So I just froze it right there, froze the simulation. The kinetic energy is very small there. The potential energy is essentially the same as it was originally. It was all potential, the total energy was all potential energy originally. It's now all potential energy again. This is the turning point on the left. I'm just going to let them go back and forth a few times. You can see turning point on the right, this interaction energy is pulling the skater toward this lowest energy point. The interaction is pulling the skater toward the lowest energy point. Skater stops at the next turning point, and then the interaction pulls the skater toward the lowest energy point. Skater is always aiming toward the lowest energy point, always being pulled to the left when he's over here on the right, and to the right when he's over here on the left. So being pulled to the left, now being pulled to the right, which means slowing down, and now being pulled to the left, which in this case means slowing down, still being pulled to the left, still slowing down, still being pulled to the left, reaches a turning point where it stops, still being pulled to the left, but now speeding up to the left. Being pulled to the left even harder, speeding up even more. Now being pulled to the right, so it slows down and stops. Now being pulled to the right, so he speeds up.